Hello everyone. So in our last video, I had told you about the background and the theme of the poem A Photograph, written by Shirley Toulson. So in today's video, we are going to start reading the poem stanza by stanza and understand its meaning. So without wasting any more time, let us begin with the video. A Photograph, written by Shirley Toulson. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girls went paddling, each holding one of my mother's hands, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born, and the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Now, in the first lines, the cardboard shows me how it was. The cardboard. The word cardboard means the photograph, which the poetess is looking at and feeling nostalgic. In the first stanza, the poetess is describing whatever she could see in the photograph. And she says that when the two girls went paddling. Now, the two girls over here are the two cousins of Shirley's mother, with whom Shirley's mother went for a sea holiday. Went paddling. Over here, the word paddling symbolizes playfulness and happiness. And she, the big girl. Now, over here, she is referred to Shirley's mother. So, at the time when this photograph was clicked, Shirley's mother's age was somewhere 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. So, these three girls were posing in order to click photograph. A sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. Over here, a sweet face. By these words, the poetess is trying to depict that everything on earth is temporary, and as time passes by, everything starts vanishing. And as a matter of fact, beauty is also temporary. So as you start aging or as time passes by, beauty also starts vanishing. She is trying to say that the incident which she is talking about in this poem, in this stanza, has happened a long time ago. And the sea, which appears to have changed less. Now, over here, by the word sea, the poetess is trying to show that the sea is permanent, whereas life is temporary. And by the word terribly transient, the poetess is trying to say that the reality of life is that it is temporary. And the word feet is used to make a comparison between human life and the nature, because human life is temporary, whereas nature is permanent. Some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. See Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter. Both wry with the labored ease of loss. So over here, some 20-30 years later means that the poetess is talking about a different time now. So in the line, some 20-30 years later, the poetess is trying to say that time has changed, and right now she is in a different situation. 20 or 30 years have already passed. She would laugh at the snapshot. Over here, she is referred to as the poetess's mother, that is Shirley's mother. At the time when the photograph was clicked, Shirley's mother was 12 years old, and now that 20 or 30 years have passed away, Shirley's mother must be 32 or 42 years old. So now this photograph has become a memory for Shirley's mother, and that's why Shirley's mother would look at the photograph and laugh at it. She would laugh at the snapshot and tell her cousins, whose names are Betty and Dolly. Shirley's mother would say, "And look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter." So, this entire line is very important, because now that 20-30 years have passed, that sea holiday has become Shirley's mother's past, Shirley's mother's happy past. And Shirley's mother is dead now at present. And that is why Shirley's mother's laughter is Shirley's past. Both wry with the labored ease of loss. Both wry over here, both refers to the past. The past of Shirley's mother and Shirley's past. That is, the sea holiday, those memories, as well as the memory of Shirley's mother, both are gone now. Both have vanished. Because the word wry means vanished, dry, no more. Now, in the words, the labored ease of loss, the poetic device used is transferred epithet, which means that the words used are grammatically correct but meaningfully incorrect. And what is the reason for that? Because labored and ease, these two words are ironical terms. They are opposite terms with opposite meanings. But over here, these two words are paired together, which is grammatically correct, but the literal meaning of these two words placed side by side is somewhat incorrect or wrong. So, labored. The word labored means that the poetess finds it very difficult to accept the reality that her mother is no more. And the word ease means that the poetess is still trying to calm herself down. She is still trying to ease and to accept the reality that her mother is no more. Now she has been dead nearly as many years as the girl lived, and of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. It's silence silences. So in the last stanza, the poetess is talking about the current present time. Now she has been dead nearly as many years. Though over here in the last stanza, she reveals that the photograph which she was talking about for so long, the memories of her mother, are actually set back in the past. Her mother is no more. Her mother is dead. And she has been dead since many years. And of this circumstance. Now, what is the meaning of the word circumstance? Circumstance means the situation of death and detachment. It means that death has separated the mother and daughter. There is nothing to say at all. By these words, the poetess is saying that the circumstance of death is unavoidable. Nobody has nothing to do in it, and that is why nobody can say anything about it. And hence, its silence silences. Now, the poetic device in the last line, its silence silences, is alliteration because of the repetition of the consonant sound S. Over here, the first silence means the death, the fact that death has separated the mother and daughter, and the fact that since death is unavoidable, nobody has anything to say about death, and death makes everybody silent. Over here, the first word silence means that since death has separated the mother and daughter, and that death is unavoidable, nobody has anything to say about it, and hence this situation of death has made everybody else silent. And the second word silences, it means the poet is very sad. She finds it hard to accept the reality that her mother is no more, but she has to accept it, and that is why she has become silent. She has nothing to say, and hence Shirley Toulson's tribute to her dead mother is finished. So I hope that you found this video helpful, and if yes, then please hit the like button.